Welcome to class 10 social science past paper analysis. Solving the previous year question papers is considered as the best practice to prepare for any board exams. It helps you know the topics which are frequently asked in the exams and also helps in evaluating your preparation level for the exam. Almost 50 to 60% of questions are repeated every year. Solving previous 5 to 10 years of question papers will help you very much in scoring good. You will get here the previous year's CBSE question papers of class 10 social science. We are going to do it in chapter wise to make it easy and systematic. Now we are going to look at frequently asked long answer questions or 5 mark questions from history chapter 1. Question number 1. What did liberal nationalism stand for? Explain any 4 ideas of liberal nationalist in the economic sphere. Liberalism or liberal nationalism stood for freedom for the individual and equality of all before the law. 4 ideas of liberal nationalist in the economic sphere are: liberalism stood for freedom of markets and abolition of state-imposed restrictions. For example, Napoleon's administration was a confederation of 29 states. Each of these possessed its own currencies, weight and measures. Such conditions were viewed as obstacles to economic exchange. Liberal nationalists argued for the creation of a unified economic territory, allowing the unhindered movement of goods, people and capital. In 1834, a customs union or sovereign was formed. The union abolished tariff barriers and reduced the number of currencies from 30 to 2. The creation of a network of railways further stimulated mobility, harnessing economic interest to national unification. Question number 2. Napoleon had no doubt destroyed democracy in France, but in the administrative field he had incorporated revolutionary principles in order to make the old system more rational and efficient. Support the statement. Explain any 5 social and administrative reforms introduced by Napoleon in regions under his control. Napoleon had brought revolutionary changes in the administrative field in order to make the old system rational and efficient. The Civil Code of 1804 is usually known as the Napoleonic Code. The first major change was doing away with all privileges based on birth, establishing equality before law and securing the right to property. Administrative divisions were simplified. Feudal system was abolished and peasants were freed from serfdom and manorial dues. In towns, guild restrictions were removed. Transport and communication systems were improved. Peasants, artisans, workers and new businessmen enjoyed a new found freedom. Businessmen and small-scale producers of goods in particular began to realize that uniform laws, standardized weights and measures and a common national currency would facilitate the movement and exchange of goods and capital from one region to another. Question number 3. How did culture play an important role in creating the idea of the nation in Europe? Explain with examples. Culture, music, dance and religion played an important role in the growth of nationalism. Role of culture was important in creating the idea of the nation. Art, poetry, music, etc. helped in developing and expressing nationalist feelings. Romanticism was a cultural movement that led to the development of nationalist sentiment. Romantic artists and poets criticized the glorification of reason and science and instead focused on emotions and intuitions. Language too played an important role in developing nationalist sentiments. after Russian occupation, the Polish language was forced out of schools and Russian language was imposed everywhere. In 1831, an armed rebellion against Russian rule took place, which was ultimately crushed. Following this, many members of the clergy in Poland began to use language as a weapon of national resistance. Romantics such as German philosopher Herder claimed that true German culture was to be discovered among the common people. It was through folk songs, folk poetry and folk dances that the true spirit of the nation was popularized. Question number 4. Explain any 5 economic hardships that Europe faced in the 1830s. It's a very important question. Following are the causes of economic hardships in Europe during 1830s. Europe had come under the grip of large-scale unemployment. In most of the countries, there were more seekers of jobs than employment. Cities had become overcrowded and slums had emerged as population from the rural areas migrated to the cities. Small producers in towns were often faced with stiff competition from imports of cheap machine-made goods from England, where industrialization was more advanced, especially in the field of textile production. In those regions of Europe where aristocracy still enjoyed power, peasants struggled under the burden of feudal dues and obligations. The rise of food prices and barn harvest added to the hardships of the peasants. Question number 5. Describe any 5 measures which were introduced by the French revolutionaries to create a sense of collective identity among the French people. The first clear-cut expression of nationalism came with the French Revolution in 1789. In 1789, France was under the rule of an absolute monarch. When the revolutionaries came to power in France, they were determined to create a new sense of unity and nationhood. For this, they emphasized the concept of France being the fatherland or la patrie for all French people, who were from now on addressed as citizens or citoyens. They were given the tricolor flag, the 3 colors representing liberty, equality and fraternity. French revolutionaries introduced various other measures, such as the estate general was elected by the body of active citizens and renamed the National Assembly. New hymns were composed, oaths were taken and martyrs were commemorated, all in the name of the nation. A centralized administrative system was put in place and it formulated uniform laws for all citizens within its territory. Internal customs, duties and dues were abolished and a uniform system of weights and measures were adopted. Regional dialects were discouraged and French, as it was spoken and written in Paris, became the common language of the nation. They further declared that it was the mission and the destiny of the French nation to liberate the people of Europe from despotism and help them to become nations. Question number 6. How had revolutionaries spread their ideas in many European states after 1815? Explain with examples. During the years following 1815, the fear of repression drove many liberal nationalists underground. Secret societies sprang up in many European states to train revolutionaries and spread their ideas. Revolutionary ideas were spread by opposing monarchical forms and to fight for liberty and freedom. Most of the revolutionaries also saw the creation of nation states as a necessary part of this struggle for freedom. Giuseppe Mazzini was an Italian revolutionary born in Geneva in 1807. He was a member of the secret society of the Carbonari. He attempted for a revolution in 1831 and was sent into exile. He had set up two more underground societies, namely Young Italy in Marseilles and then Young Europe in Bernay. The members were like-minded young men from Poland, France, Italy and Germany. He opposed monarchy and small states and kingdoms and dreamt of a democratic republic. He believed the unification of Italy alone could be the basis of Italian liberty. Question number 7. Describe the process of unification of Germany. In the 18th century, Germany was divided into a number of states. Some of the states ceased to exist during the Napoleonic Wars. At the end of the war, there were still 39 independent states in Germany. Prussia was most powerful, dominated by big landlords known as Junkers. Nationalist feelings were widespread among middle-class Germans who had tried to unite the different regions of the German Federation into a nation-state governed by an elected parliament. In May 1848, a large number of political associations came together to vote for an all-German National Assembly. The representatives met at Frankfurt, and the Frankfurt Assembly proposed the unification of Germany as a constitutional monarchy under the King of Prussia as emperor. The King of Prussia rejected the offer, and the liberal initiative of nation building was repressed by combined forces of the monarchy, the military and the Junkers. Then on, Prussia under its chief minister Otto von Bismarck led the movement for unification of Germany. Bismarck carried out this process with the help of the Prussian army and the bureaucracy. He fought three wars over 7 years with Denmark, Austria and France. Prussia was victorious in all these wars, and the process of unification was completed as a result of Prussia's victory over France. Consequently, on 18th January 1871, an assembly comprising of princes of German states, representatives of the army, important Prussian ministers and Bismarck gathered in the Palace of Versailles and proclaimed the Prussian king, Kaiser Wilhelm, the new German emperor. Question number 8. Explain the process of unification of Italy. Italy too had a long history of political fragmentation. Italians were scattered over dynastic states and the multinational Habsburg Empire. Italy was divided into 7 states. Italian language did not have one common form. Giuseppe Mazzini had played an important role in the unification of Italy. He formed a secret society called Young Italy in Marseilles to spread his goals. He believed Italy could not continue to be a patchwork of small states and had to be forged into a single unified republic. During 1830s, Mazzini sought to put together a coherent program for a unitary Italian republic. As uprisings in 1831 and 1848 had failed, the mantle now fell on Sardinia Piedmont under its ruler Emmanuel II to unify Italy. Under Chief Minister Cavour, Sardinia Piedmont succeeded in defeating the Austrian forces in 1859. He was the chief minister who led the movement to unify Italy. He formed a tactful diplomatic alliance with France and defeated the Austrian forces. Even Giuseppe Garibaldi joined the movement. In 1860, they marched towards South Italy and the Kingdom of the Two Sicilies, and with the help of the local peasants, drove out the Spanish rulers. In 1861, Victor Emmanuel II was proclaimed as King of United Italy. Question number 9. Describe the process of unification of Britain, or how has Britain come into existence? Explain. Nationalism in Britain was different from the rest of Europe. Nationalism in Britain was not the result of a sudden uprising or revolution. It was the result of a long drawn out process. There was no British nation prior to 18th century. The inhabitants of British Isles were ethnic ones, English, Welsh, Scot or Irish. Though each had their own culture and political traditions, The English nation steadily grew in wealth, importance and power and expanded its influence over other nations such as Scotland. The British Parliament was dominated by its English members. They tried to suppress Scotland's distinct culture and political institutions. They could neither speak their language nor could they wear their national dress. A large number of them were driven out of their homeland. In 1688, through a bloodless revolution, the English Parliament seized power from the monarchy and became the instrument to set up a nation state at its center. By the Act of Union in 1707, Scotland was incorporated in the United Kingdom. Though the Irish Catholics were against a union with England, Ireland was forcibly incorporated in United Kingdom in 1801. Thus, it was parliamentary action and not revolution or war that was the instrument through which the British nation was formed. A new British nation was formed through propagation of English culture, the symbols of the New Britain, the British flag called Union Jack, national anthem called God Save Our Noble King, and the English language were promoted, and the older nations became the subordinate partners in the Union. This is all about long answer questions from chapter 1. Thank you for watching.